हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू योर लाइब्रेरी क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस क्लास आई विल नरेट यू अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी फ्रॉम योर ऑल टाइम फेवरेट स्टोरीज बुक. किड्स, स्टोरीज प्ले अ वाइटल रोल इन द ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन. दे आर अ great way to introduce new words and ideas into a child's language. Stories improve our language learning, confidence level, and also help instill moral values in children. So kids, in this class I will narrate you the story Who Will Bell the Cat from your story book. In this class, first of all, I will discuss with you the main characters along with the summary of the story. Then we will discuss all the difficult words with their meaning. After that, I will read the story along with you, and at the end, I will discuss the cross questions. Now, let's start. The main characters in the story are a cat, mice, and a farmer. Now, kids, let's start with the summary. Once upon a time, there lived a very hard-working farmer in a village. He had stored grams in his house. One day, Chiku, a mouse, saw the grains and called the whole army of mice. All these mice made burrows in the walls of farmer's house and started eating the grains. The farmer got worried as the mice would spoil and eat all his grains. So he made a plan to get a pet cat. The smart cat used to hunt the mouse and made the army of the mice weak. One day, all the mice called a meeting to get rid of the cat. One of the mouse suggested to bell the cat so that whenever the cat would be around them, they would quickly save them. Everyone was happy, but one problem was still there, that who will tie a bell around the cat's neck? No mouse came forward for it, as no one had the courage to go near the cat. In the end, the mice decided to leave the farmer's home and find a new home for them. So kids, how was the story? Quite interesting, right? Now, let's discuss the difficult words with their meanings. Number one is sacks. S-A-C-K-S, sacks, means jute bags. Number two, sneaked. S-N-E-A-K-E-D, sneaked, means move in very quietly. Number three, quickly. Q-U-I-C-K-L-Y, quickly, means fast. Number four, burrows. B-U-R-R-O-W-S, burrows, means a hole in the ground. Number five is feast. F-E-A-S-T, feast, means a large meal. Number six is began. B-E-G-A-N, began, means to start. Number seven is drag. D-R-A-G, drag means to pull. Number 8 is worried. W-O-R-R-I-E-D, worried, mean anxious. Number 9 is decided. D-E-C-I-D-E-D, decided, means to make a choice. Number 10 is hunt. H-U-N-T, hunt, means to search and eat. Number 11 is assembly. A-S-S-E-M-B-L-Y, assembly, means where many people get together. Number 12 is suggested. S-U-G-G-E-S-T-E-D, suggested, means to give advice. Number 13 is cheered. C-H-E-E-R-E-D, cheered, means became happy. Number 14 is conversation. C-O-N-V-E-R-S-A-T-I-O-N, conversation, means a chat. Number 15 is silent. S-I-L-E-N-T, silent, means quiet. Number 16 is mice. M-I-C-E, mice, means plural of mouse. So kids, it's our reading time. Let's begin with the reading. Side by side, I will tell you the meanings of the difficult words. Once upon a time, there lived a very hard-working farmer in a village. He had stored many sacks of grains in his house. Here, underline the word sacks and write down jute bags. J-U-T-E, jute, B-A-G-S, bags, jute bags. One day, Chiku Mouse sneaked into his house. Underline the word sneak and write down move in quietly. M-O-V-E, move, I-N, in, V-E-R-Y, very, Q-U-I-E-T-L-Y, quietly, moving very quietly. He was so happy to see so many sacks of grains. He quickly ran and got his whole army of mice. Here, underline the word quickly and write down fast. F-A-S-T, fast. In the same line, underline the word mice and write down plural of mouse. P-L-U-R-A-L, plural O-F of M-O-U-S-E, mouse. Plural of mouse. All these mice made burrows in the walls of the farmer's house and began to feast on the grains. Here, underline the word burrows and write down a hole in the ground. A H-O-L-E, hole, I-N-N, T-H-E, the, G-R-O-U-N-D, ground, a hole in the ground. In the next line, underline the word feast and write down a large meal. A L-A-R-G-E, large, M-E-A-L, meal, a large meal. Soon, they began to pick up little things from the house and drag them into their burrows. In this line, underline the word began and write down to start. T-O-2-S-T-A-R-T, start, to start. In the next line, underline the word drag and write down to pull. T-O-2-P-U-L-L, pull. So kids, in these lines, they are talking about a very hard-working farmer in a village. He had stored many grains in his house. One day, when Chiku Mouse saw all these grains, he called the whole army of mice to the farmer's house. And all these mice made burrows in the walls of the house and started eating the grains. Now let's continue with the reading. The farmer got very worried on seeing so many mice. He thought, if I don't do something quickly, they will eat up all my grain. Here, underline the word worried and write down anxious. A-N-X-I-O-U-S, anxious. He decided to get a pet cat. Underline the word decided and write down to make a choice. T-O-2-M-A-K-E, make a C-H-O-I-C-E, choice. To make a choice. The cat was very smart and she began to hunt the mice from all corners of the house. Slowly, the army of the mice became weaker and lesser in number. Here, in the second line, underline the word hunt and write down T-O-2-S-E-A-R-C-H, search, A-N-D and E-A-T, eat, to search and eat. So kids, on seeing all these mice, the farmer got really worried, as the mice would spoil and eat all his grains. So he made a plan to get a pet cat, and his plan worked really very well, as the smart cat used to hunt the mice from all the corners of the house, and this made the army of the mice weak. Now let's continue with the reading. So, one day all the mice called an assembly. Underline the word assembly and write down W-H-E-R-E-V-I-L, N-A-N-Y, many, P-E-O-P-L-E, people, G-E-T, get, T-O-G-E-T-H-E-R, together, where many people get together. They began to think of a solution to their cat problem. One mouse suggested, let's tie a bell around the cat's neck. This way, we would know when she would be around. We can quickly run into our burrows and save our lives. Here, in the third line, underline, suggested and write down to give advice. T-O-2-G-I-V-E, give, A-D-V-I-C-E, advice. So kids, one day all the mice called a meeting to get rid of the cat. One of the mouse suggested to bell the cat so that whenever the cat would be around them, they would quickly run from there. Everyone cheered at the suggestion and began to jump about. Underline the word cheered and write down became happy. B-E-C-A-M-E, became, H-A-P-P-Y, happy, became happy. And old mouse was sitting in a corner listening to all the conversation. Underline the word conversation and write down a chat. C-H-A-T, chat. He cleared his throat and said, which one of you will put the bell around the cat's neck? The room fell silent. Underline the word silent and write down quiet, quiet. No one was brave enough to get close to the cat. Everyone decided that it was best to find a new home. So kids, while everyone was happy at the suggestion, a wise old mouse came forward and asked, "But who will bell the cat?" The room fell silent. No mouse came forward for it, as no one had the courage to go near the cat. In the end, the mice decided to leave the farmer's home and find a new home for them. So, the moral of the story is, it is important to have courage to be able to do anything. Okay kids, with this our reading is done. Now, let's discuss some cross questions. First question is, what problem did the farmer face? And the answer is, the farmer faced the problem that the mice were destroying his grains. Second question is, what solution did the farmer try? And the answer is, the farmer got a pet cat as a solution. Third question is, what happened when the cat came? Answer is, when the cat came, the mice reduced in number. Fourth question is, why did the mice call an assembly? And the answer is, the mice called an assembly to find a solution to the cat problem. Fifth question is, why was no one able to bell the cat? And the answer is, no one was able to bell the cat because they did not have the courage to go near the cat. Okay kids, I hope you all have liked the story. So, we will meet you in the next session. Thank you. Have a nice day.